And good evening, everyone. This is Lightly Held Opinions. I guess we're gonna make some progress tonight on G3, Blue AF, and probably some COP. Because why not? Let's start with the blue AF. Cause I already got the prep work done for that yesterday. I also need to clear out my inventory. Good, we're getting a cutscene. Hold on. Okay, so I'm supposed to say gaze away. Say, I have. Oh, wait. Okay. All right. So I have to go to the 5 staging points now. All right. I don't think. Well, I mean, I'll check to see, but I don't think I can teleport to any of them other than Azu Vile, which is the one I did. But if I can, I've got the Imperial Standing to do so. So let's find out. I'm 99% sure, though. I'm going to have to do it the long way. Yep. Well, let me at least do this one. All right, so I need to do Azuf, Vuka, Mamulja, Halvung, and Ilrusia Toll. Alright. I should get a brand when I talk to this, to the person here. Brand of the Stone Serpent. Alright, good. One down. Now I got to go unlock all the others. Alright, I'll need to get some Imperial Silver pieces as well. Thank you. Let me go grab. Well, let me see. I need that one for Dvuka Isle, Halvung. Okay. Don't need anything for that one. Ilrusi Atoll. I need to get a Lemmy and Fang King key for that. Well, it looks like I can get there from Dvuka Isle staging point. And that's what I need the Imperial Silver Piece for. Let me go get the Imperial Silver Piece for that one. Oh, yeah, that's right. I was going to check to see if there'd be any others that I needed. Okay. Just need the one silver piece. Yeah, I do not have any Imperial silver pieces. So I guess once I get this, I can go to Nashmal, because that's going to be where I have to go to do most of these. Okay, good news is I still have Sanction up. All right, off to Nashmile. Let's take the west exit. Okay. Go west at find Nashifa at E11. That'll be where I trade my Imperial Silver coin, right? Yes. Thank you. All right, there's E11. However, why is there a home point here? Let me go grab that. I'm sure I don't have that one. God, it's a graveyard. Getting around this thing was a nightmare. Yep. Dismount here and grab this. And now let's go back to E11. Trade her the coin. Get the heck out of here. Straight and use the teleporter on the right side. Ah, the undersea ruins. Okay. It just goes straight into your zone back into Kaderva Mire. Does this take me out to? And then they just said, hug the right wall. Yeah, there it is. Okay, cool. Better than sneaking in Viz. Oh. I gotta wait 30 seconds because I'm an idiot. Okay. Yeah, that's some scary stuff. Also, I'm really glad I didn't put up sneak and invis and be like, oh, let me run up there. They're true sight. Nope, they're blood. Never mind. They're not true sight. They're blood aggro. Nonetheless. But I'm going to have to blow some Imperial Standing here so that I can unlock the portals. Can I unlock it without teleporting? I don't think so. Alright, and now I come back to Vuka Isle. Because it's like I can get to Arusi Atoll from that staging point. So I don't need the Lamian Fang Key if I take this path. Okay. Says I need a Rapido Reef at H8. Yeah, so I could, it's that thing labeled 2 on my map there. Man, I wish they'd let me change the music for the Raptor. Rapido Reef. Okay. So it says I have to leave it H. Okay. I don't think I can mount here. All right, since I can't. First iron door at H. Fallen Imperial Trooper. Well, they would probably kill me. Here's the first iron door. All right. Go northeast until I see a I need to go where the map is marked C. Okay. Yeah, it says follow the tunnel line of the open, head north until you see an area with Jnun, cross it, turn right and head southeast across the plank. So yeah, I see where that is. Hopefully nothing here is true sight. Fallen Imperial Wizard. Nope. Chantress. Nope. Yeah, there's the Jnun. And then I am going to... what? Okay, once I get here, what does it tell me to do? Head northeast until I see a ship at G8, cross it and take a left. Okay, I see where the ship is. Currently E11, yeah. It's that long, diagonal, rectangular looking thing. Still have over a minute on my sneaking advis. What's an ush? Well, this will be a good spot to redo this because they are not aggro. All right, after I cross, cross to take a left, go as west as possible. Okay, I see the ship there. The one left two and up one from where I'm currently at. How do I get off this ship? Ah, here. Kabuki Dancer. Nope, not true sight. Ice Dancer, not true sight. Okay. Once I do that, it says G5. So, oh, I see where the staging point is. It's helpfully labeled on my map. Alright, so I'll have over a minute. This is a bad spot to reapply. So this is a long-ish run, but honestly, it's easier than the alternative. I gotta loop around. Alright, below 1 minute, so let's find a convenient spot, like right here. Reapply, and this should be the last time I have to do this. Because the staging point is close enough. Just don't give me imps or anything. Don't give me something with true sight. Oh, crap. Yeah, I cannot mount Raptor here. Well, he's got his back to me. Nope, 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 nope. I need him to move. I'll just wait. Yeah, they are true sight. If I can make it past these three, I think I'm probably okay. All right, he's going the other way. Yeep. Whew. Okay, that part was not fun. Oh. Okay. Okay. Halvug and Mamul Zha, I think, are the other two I need. And both I leave from Al Jabi, I believe. Yeah. Cool. So. Three brands down. Two to go. Pretty sure it's... excuse me. I don't need the Nizel Isle for this. I don't believe. I just need... well, let me back up and make sure. Yeah. I just need Halvung and Mamul Zha still. Up looking. Well, let's teleport to 4. All right. Buffalo Thickets. And then I need to walk back out to Wajum Woodlands, it says. Alright. Well, we're going to do as much as we can on Chocobo. Let me go ahead and refresh my sanction. Pretty sure this is the complicated one, and that Hulvung is a lot easier. Alright, west and south, cave D12. That's a ways. Can't get any further out. D12 is a long way away. We will continue. Thank you. G-F-E. Okay, so it's the one labeled 1 on the map in green over there. Wow, that's a ways away. All right, into Momok I go. Okay, let me look at the... So I need to get there. Oh, hey, a survival guide. Grab that real quick. And then sneak up. Zenist is safe to go by. Savant is safe to go by. Sophist, okay. I need to zoom in. And it's saying... All right. Alright, now I need to go up this ramp here. Ziz, they're safe. I've still got over a minute. I'm good. For the love of God, don't let me run into a true sight or true hearing. Mamul. Zenith is fine. Savant is fine. All right. Sophist is fine. Oh, what's here? Spinner. Oh, good. Spinners aren't even aggro. So we can take advantage of that and reapply. And now I just have to be careful not to fall. Like, real careful not to fall. Because getting back is going to be a pain. Yeah, like, don't fall down there. It's a very long path to get all the way back around. All All right, I got lucky, didn't run into any of the TrueSight ones. No, I don't fall there. I keep going up. And I'm pretty sure I could just mount up here in Buffalo Thickets. So that'll make things easier. Yeah, head south to H11 and go to the staging point. Ah, I may also go up there and grab the home point. Scuffin. Maybe I don't want to get this home point. No, I can put around the corner. Okay, good. Now let's go to the staging area. These guys are scary because they are way higher level than I am. Okay. And the Halvung staging point. Buffalo to Halvung to Mount Jhelum. And I believe all of those I am allowed to ride my mount in. We'll find out. Brand of the Sky Serpent. All right, one to go. Don't honestly remember in Halvung if I'm allowed to use my mount or not. They don't mount just Jhelum.
beached looking.
Everyone's at level zero in training. All right, so it's not going to happen for a long time. F8 in Buffalo Thickets. Fine. We're at I-10 right now, so. Sorry about that. Now I don't have escape, so head southwest to K7, then north across the bridge. I cannot use my mount here, can I? All right. So it says what? Southwest to K7. Then north across the bridge. Okay, all right. And then head south in the zone in J7. So there's got to be a zone somewhere. We'll figure it out.
You have food, James.
No. You have food. Oh, well, did it too early. Got the survival guide. Wait a few seconds here, get my jig back up. Southwest to K7. I mean, I could probably beat some of these things. It would be a lot of effort. North across the bridge, then head south in the zone to J7. Okay, I see where that is. It's that little... It's like a little purple dot, I think. Magmatic Oruka. Yeah, it's saying when I hit this bridge, I gotta go north. and loop around. Which, okay. Troll Engraver. This K7, and then come up and around here, and it should zone me at J7, it says. The Aruka are aggro. Nope. Okay, hold on. Then south to the zone in J7. Oh, I'm still in K7. I see. Oh, this is the north across the bridge. Well. Yeah, no, I need to go south on this side. Just past that troll, there's a... I could turn right and it'll take me to the zone line. Okay. I feel a little bit better now. And this gets me to Mount Zhelum. And it says head north to L6, west to K7, and finally north to K6 in the heavy iron gate. Can I mount here? I can. Great. I should probably look to see, is there a... Nope, there's not. I was looking to see if there was a survival guide. And I can see on the map where I have to go. I remember this area vaguely. It's been a long time since I've been here, but I actually did, like, fight here before. Lots and lots and lots of trolls. It's the last staging point. So let me talk to Wadeen here. It took me about an hour to do all this. Just hit me that I hadn't actually done that. I know I've got all five brands. I can check that, but I know I have all five. I teleported back with all, so I have access to all of them from the Chamber of Passage. So now it is time to go talk to Waud. It is entirely too late in the day for me to do Castle Estrosia. That's going to be the long one. For G3. I'm getting hungry. I may not do G3 right now. I may put that off till tomorrow. Or whenever I next stream. I think I have to zone before I get the next quest. I have to zone and wait one in-game day. So yeah, let's go ahead and do G3. Let's start with Devoy. Yeah, this one I'm actually going to have to... I'm gonna eventually get cursed here. Because I don't have the Crimson Orb. That's fine. We're all fine. I don't think I need them out, but just in case, I may get attacked near the zone into the Monastic Cavern. I shouldn't need them in the Monastic Cavern, because if I get attacked, I'm dead anyway. But yeah, the other thing I absolutely need to do soon, certainly by the time I get rank 6, is get all of my base trusts. And that includes, you know, then picking up things like Ajitomo, Regito, you know, the third tier ones, and then Shantotto. Even though I have Shantotto too, just I need to start filling out the roster. I may as well take advantage of, you know, getting a little bit of XP here. Battle dance, did I learn it? I did not. Sounds like someone dropped something. All right. With soldier, sure. Anyone gonna give me a heal? Thank you. Chess key. All right. I don't need summon them this time. Master level 19 thief. Ooh. I don't know what master levels are. Well, anyway, so it looks like there's going to be a whole lot of stuff to do to just grind, grind, grind. This is my shocked face. All right. At this level, I'm going to need what? Need to get to the wall of banishing here. I need to leave this area, get back into Devoy, and then get to the wall of banishing, touch it, and then go talk to the NPC. That's what I remember. I hope that's correct. elemental nearby. Alright, complain you can't recast. And now cast Kapipi. Let's hope nobody is standing very close to the wall. These guys are sight, if I remember right. Yes, they are sight. Oh, I think somebody's already cleared it out down there. I honestly, I could probably get him to help me get through, but I'd rather go get the Crimson Orb. I like doing these things. All right. Can I just drop down here? No, I've got a... Well, you know what? Let me go check and see if he's undoing it, because if he is, and I can sneak in, I can finish this. I can do the Crimson Orb whenever. Be right back. I'm back. How is he doing? Oh, he's fine. He's fine. All right, I'm going to go do the... what am I trying to say? I'm going to go do the Crimson Orb. Okay. Have to be careful here because there is a true site. There is a true site. Orc up here. So I just have to be careful not to be seen by him. All right. First pond. Way up here. Carefully dip the orb in the pool. It's pink. There's number two, there's number three, and there's number four. Yeah, I'm high enough level, and my team's high enough level that we can handle all of the pool guys. We are not high enough level to handle an NM, a true sight NM. That will wreck my shit. So. Yeah, level 40. There's another tier in here that's like level 50 guys, but again, I'm 56, so it won't be a problem. All right, red orb. Hmm. Oh no, I'm being attacked. Whatever shall I do? Where's my team? Okay, I'm confused. All right, so I don't die. I don't know why they didn't come with me, but... Okay, the good news is that didn't actually, like, slow me down. Let me pop into my my mug house so I heal real quick. While I'm here, check my delivery box. Nope. I don't honestly remember if anything else up for sale, but let's quickly go get this one. Val. No. Skip Tenzin is who it did. Need Kapi because I'm gonna get cursed. That's okay though. It's the last one I need, and then I can go get through the Wall of Banishing. dip the orb into the pool. And I'm cursed. But I have my crimson orb. Or I have my cursed orb. It'll become crimson here shortly. Huh. Just need you BB to cast curse now. Alright, now it's just me and Kupipi. Gotta go back through the monastic cavern. Gotta get to the Wall of Banishing, and then I gotta get to the Orcish Crest. Welcome, welcome. Hope you're having a good night. Yeah, I'm not going to find anything in here. Just going to go straight through. Will bring out the party when I'm back outside Monastic Cavern, because chances of me getting attacked at the Wall of Banishing are just too great. have Val pull the hate off me, and then I can pop through the wall and zone. Plenty of time. Yeah, unfortunately, I took a lot longer on my AF weapon than I thought it was going to. So I am probably going to break after I get done with the void here and get me some dinner. Looks like he's still fighting everyone right there at the gate. Yes, now you explain. Crimson Orb. Go barrier busting. Hopefully he's still there attacking everything. That would be really nice. Well, maybe. Huh. Nothing is looking at it right now. Hell yeah. They just all happen to be facing away. That was fortunate. I don't necessarily need them here, but let's... Oh yeah, also, is Warpring is up. Good. That was the other thing I needed, just in case I get attacked. Sprint to the other side, grab the crest, and get out. Pocket party out. Jig up. Now I know there are True Sight ones here, but I shouldn't actually run into them. It's like the black mage in the center. Don't remember what his name was. Warlord? Yeah, the Warlord. He is True Sight. So I need to avoid him. Okay, good. He's walking away. And then the crest is just up here on the left. If I remember right, there's not even a one right by it. Yeah, here we go. And there we are. Okay, so I'm going to take care of getting the Yagudo crest and the Quadav crest in my next session. I'm really hungry, so I'm going to go eat. But anyway, one third of G3 is now complete, and we've got my artifact weapon. So I guess the next one will be complete G3, and we start working on my artifact armor. So, till then, y'all have a great time. Peace, everyone.